Hey everybody, it's John Bay, CEO of Standard Uranium. Today I'm here with Sean Hilliker, VP of Exploration. We're going to be talking about today's news release, talking about the results that came out from Davidson River Summer Drill Program and some of the samples coming out of Sundog. So, we've had three drill programs at our Davidson River Program and the results are getting better and better. Sean, walk us through some of the results from today's news release and why we're excited about what's coming up this summer.
Sounds good, John. I mean, you know, like you said, we're continually building on our results each time. Every time we go back to the project with an additional drill program, you know, we're using all that data that we've collected from our past programs to build on that and really focus in on to, you know, where we want to be drilling on those conductors. So, you know, our team, we've done a fantastic job of really evaluating the conductors that we have quickly. You know, we're moving fast, we're not wasting money, we're really focusing our drill hole dollars in the ground and, you know, vectoring in on something that looks good. So the results that came out today, you know, just the final few holes that we had on our Bronco trend. Yeah. The Bronco trend is, you know, one of the most promising looking trends on the project so far.
Yeah.
The technical team's very excited. You know, we're the most excited we've been on the Davidson River project to date. So, you know, we're really excited to get back there later this summer and continue drilling it. So we're seeing, you know, really good looking structures with the graphite, the sulfides that we talk about all the time, some increased alteration products that we're looking for along Bronco as well in these holes, and then elevated trace elements and other things in the geochem. So the important takeaway from these technical news releases is to really look at that geochem and be like, okay, are we seeing anything that indicates we're in the right area?
Yeah.
And that's what we're seeing. We're seeing elevations in certain different elements like boron, you know, uranium is elevated itself in certain areas, and we're seeing those elements elevated with the structures. So having that package deal is really important to what we want to see.
Awesome. Now, on top of that, you know, our viewers really want to know that what we're trying to do up there, and that is to make a high-grade uranium discovery.
Exactly.
And we're getting closer and closer to that. So in 2022, we've got two drill programs going. We're going to be drilling the Davidson River again this summer.
With two drills.
With two drills, that's right, crushing through some holes. But before that, we're going up to Sundog.
Yes.
So we're going to be drilling Sundog this winter, starting in the end of February, early March, and drilling probably aiming for about 3,000 meters if all goes well.
Yep.
We just got some samples back today. Those were high-grade samples. Walk us through what those were like.
For sure. So you and I went up there October 14th for a site visit. That was the first time, you know, you and I got boots on the ground up there. It's beautiful country up there. Really excited to get up there and start working.
Yes.
And we actually grabbed a handful of samples when we were up there.
So with our gloves on.
Exactly. Yes, all the appropriate PPE, of course. So we grabbed four different samples and all four of them returned over 1% U308, which is what we consider high grade. So we had 1.08, you know, 2.54. The highest one that came back was 2.95% U308, which is very high grade. And it's great to see that right at surface. So what we're going to do with this drill program is we're going to come up there using our modern techniques, our modern understanding of these deposits.
Yep.
We know that there's uranium there at surface in the sandstones.
Yes.
We're going to look in the basement rocks in these structures as well. And we're going to follow up on these things we see at surface at depth.
Yes.
So we're going to get up there in a few weeks here and get the drills spinning.
Now the drillers that are going to be drilling this for us, tell us a bit about them and their experiences.
Absolutely. You know, Brady Stokes is one of the founders of Base Diamond Drilling. That's who we're going to be using for this program coming up. Him and I are good friends. We've worked together lots in the past. He was one of the top drillers, foreman, and then moved up his way through aggressive drilling when I was at Next Gen Energy. So, you know, he's a phenomenal driller, really knows what he's doing, and he's built a great team of really knowledgeable guys who have great experience in this area. So it's tough drilling, you know, at Davidson River. Sundog is going to be, you know, basically a cakewalk base compared to that, so that's nice. But so that's who we're using. We're really excited to get those guys up there, and they're going to smash it for us.
Good. So we're going to get up there at the end of February. They're going to start drilling. What's it going to be like at Uranium City in the middle of March?
It's going to be really cold.
Yeah.
There's going to be a lot of snow up there. The ice road up to Uranium City is open today, which is great. So we're actually, you know, getting things moving right now as we speak. So, you know, things are ticking along nice, and it's going to be cold and white up there. So hopefully we can get up there for a visit and show everybody what it's like.
Yeah, so for our audience, Uranium City, in the northern part of Lake Athabasca, to get there in the winter, that lake freezes, and they build actual an ice road across that. They drive the trucks across, we get all our gear there, and then the guys operate on trucks and snowmobiles to get around.
That's correct, yep.
How many drills are we going to have going at the Sundog project, and how are the guys getting around, like from the fishing lodge to the thing? maybe walk us through some of that.
Yeah, sounds good. We're going to be staying out of Indian Head Fishing Lodge. It's owned by Wendy and Greg McMillan. They're a great couple to work with. So they've been kind enough to work with us. That's going to be our base of operations there out on Stewart Island.
Yep.
And we're going to actually push an ice road down from the main road from Uranium City all the way down right to our Sundog project. So the Saskatchewan Research Council is actually remediating an old uranium mine up there on our project. So we're able to work with them and, you know, have a lot of cost savings there and save that ice road. So we're going to be doing that. We're going to have one drill up there for now for our inaugural program. And yeah, we're going to get up there and these guys are going to drill quickly and hopefully we'll be drilling for about 5 weeks.
Awesome. Well, I can't wait to get up there, film some videos from our Sundog drill program this February, March.
Yep.
And of course, share that information with you, our audience. So if you have any more questions, fire away, send them to us. It's John Bay, CEO, Sean Hilliker, VP of Exploration, coming to you from Standard Uranium. Cheers.
Cheers.